Kundalini Awakening. Seventh or eighth century. The earliest documented evidence of the knowledge of Kundalini Yoga is in the great Indian epic Ramayana. In that, the author Maharishi Valmiki initiates two young boys, Love and Kush, into Kundalini awakening. He explains to the two children that the power of Kundalini can only be transmitted from a great master, and the receiver is bestowed with extraordinary powers. Centuries later, 2012. Kundalini. One can't ignore its existence, nor the influence and impact it is creating in human consciousness, even today. What is Kundalini, and why is it given such an important place in the history of human consciousness?
From the beginning of human life on planet Earth, Indian sages, Indian rishis, Indian enlightened beings were constantly developing techniques, methods, processes to awaken the Kundalini of the individual and mass. We have the most refined Kundalini awakening system available. This energy is described in different ways in different yogic literatures, Vedic literatures. The awakening methods, thousands of methods are used by different gurus, different masters, different saints, different sages, different incarnations.
The Yajurveda, a primary sacred text of the Vedic civilization, declares Yatha Pinde Tatha Brahmande, Yatha Brahmande Tatha Pinde. As in the individual, so in the universe. As in the universe, so in the individual. The Vedic worldview is shaped by the principle of the universal hologram, where the tiniest subatomic particle holds the key to the secrets of the entire cosmos. A hologram is a complex structure wherein every part is a complete and faithful reflection of the whole. As a fragment of this universal hologram, every individual is a perfect microcosm, a flawless and adequate representation of the forces governing the cosmos. When Kundalini manifests at the universal level, she is known as Parakundalini, the supreme power of the cosmos. When she plays in the individual, she is the gracious mother, the life force that nourishes the body, the energy that empowers his mind, and the conscious power that guides him to his ultimate spiritual fulfillment.
When the Kundalini is awakened, all the mental patterns and physical patterns are broken, destroyed, a new higher pattern, conscious pattern gets evolved, which is completely based on freedom.
The Shiva Samhita declares Supta Guru Prasadena Yatha Jagrati Kundali Tatha Sarvani Padmani Bidyante Grantha Yopicha. When the sleeping Kundalini is awakened by the Guru's grace, then are all bondages, fears, or broken. Paramahamsa Nityananda is one such rare being who lives and moves amongst us today. A young, charismatic, enlightened master from India, Paramahamsa Nityananda is also a Siddha Yogi, spiritual healer, orator, author, and the founder of an international socio-spiritual organization with followers in 154 countries. He is the 293rd pontiff of Madurai Adhinam, one of India's ancient and traditional mutt. He is the heir of a 5,000-year-old lineage of enlightened yogis who live and train on the legendary mountain of Arunachala in southern India. Nityananda is an adept in the mystical yogic sciences whose fulcrum is the awakening of the mighty Kundalini energy. In a landmark energy expression on our planet, Nityananda has been awakening the Kundalini of hundreds of thousands of ordinary people beyond the limitations of time and space with just a glance, a touch, or a wave of his hand.
Time and space does not bind Kundalini energy. It serves Kundalini energy. A person's Kundalini can be awakened wherever he may be sitting, whatever time it may be.
Kundalini literally means the coiled one, meaning infinite, untapped potential of the universe. Verse 82 of Yoga Kundalini Upanishad says, the Shakti named Kundalini, which is like a thread in the lotus and is resplendent, is biting with the upper end of its hood at the root of the lotus, the Moolakanda. Through the human body flow 72,000 subtle energy channels called Nadi. Of these channels, the most prominent is Sushumna, which runs from the tip of the spine to the crown of the head. Running alongside the Sushumna on either side and crisscrossing it at intervals are the Ida and Pingala Nadi. Kundalini energy or Shakti is said to sleep in each of us in the Mooladhara Chakra, the energy center at the base of the spine. The goal of all Kundalini Yoga is to awaken and guide this energy up the Sushumna Nadi to the Sahasrara Chakra, the energy center at the crown of the head, where Shiva or pure consciousness resides. The blissful union of energy and consciousness, Shakti and Shiva, is enlightenment, the culmination of all spiritual effort. Adi Shankaracharya, the legendary Hindu saint in his composition Saundarya Lahari, describes the awakening of the six chakras and activation of divine serpent power. These verses say that siddhis like Vaibhav is present in Mooladhara, Shanti Sheetalata in Swadhisthana, Amritavarsha in Manipuraka, Ritambra Pragya and 18 Vidyas in Anahata, and blissful divine light is present in Vishuddhi. The Shiva principle lies in the Anya Chakra, and the great divine union is present in the Sahasrara Chakra. These attainments are so great that a person becomes divine.
Let me explain remarkable effects of Kundalini energy. What all can happen in your day-to-day life if your Kundalini is awakened? First thing, it completely reorganizes your whole body. It's almost like rebooting. The health, tremendous health. Diseaselessness is not health, it is one part of health. Health is using your body as you want, just by will.
The sleeping Kundalini is a metaphor for the unawakened potential inside us.
When you do a Kundalini energy program lasting about 21 days, the mitochondria level actually went up 1,300 times as opposed to an average of 30-40% during normal gym activities or yoga. Now, this is definite indirect proof. The human being has an average of 25,000 to 30,000 genes, out of which only about 10,000 are expressed at a given time. Recently, we studied the genes on the candidates who attended the Inner Awakening program, and to our surprise, we could shortlist about 7 genes which were uniquely expressed consistently in almost all the participants of the program. One of the examples is something called a heat shock protein, which is related to combating environmental stress in all living organisms, from the earthworm to the human being. It's a common gene. And the levels of expression of this gene went up uniquely. There's one more gene, for example, called the CRH gene, which related to neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and so on. And this also increased phenomenally during the program. However, during Kundalini awakening, you are simultaneously alert as well as asleep. In other words, you are in a state of restful awareness. In yogic literature, the snake metaphor is used for Kundalini Shakti, represented by a coiled serpent, which stands for potential or latent energy, just waiting to be uncoiled and released.
Without first awakening Kundalini, it is impossible to awaken the Pratyakatma Chaitanya, the awakened individual consciousness. Kundalini is known by many names: the universal energy, the great cosmic mother, creative force of the universe. But the simple truth is, Kundalini is the highest potential of every individual, the ultimate expression of creative genius. The awakening of Kundalini opens us up to the greater reality beyond our limited individual selves. It empowers us to harness the cosmic powers to live more complete, fulfilled, and blissful lives. The human performance drastically increases with Kundalini awakening.
Playing with all extraordinary energies of the universe is your birthright. 200 years before, a mainstream human society was not believing we can fly, but now we are flying. Every day millions are flying from one place to another. Same way, now the mainstream humanity may not be able to accept telepathy, teleportation, materialization, all these are possible. But I hope, and I'll do it at least within next 10 years, the teleportation and telepathy will become a common part of human life, like flying today. Experiencing these extraordinary powers and experiences is the one of the effects of Kundalini awakening. Your brain is hardwired to experience extraordinary powers. Awakening your Kundalini energy means awakening all the non-mechanical parts of your brain, the capacity to face the life and capacity to play with all the extraordinary energies of life.
Kundalini can be awakened in different ways: through intense yogic practices lasting a lifetime, or through Diksha, the direct transmission of spiritual energy by an awakened being. Of these, Diksha is the most effortless and certainly the most beautiful way to awakening. For an open receiver, a moment of Diksha can do more than a lifetime of spiritual effort. The first instance of Kundalini awakening is always a pure gift from the spiritual master.
When he came close enough for me to see, he came forehead to forehead, close enough for me to see, I saw a aged, wrinkled, beautiful old man with deep pool wisdom of eyes, and just so much wisdom and understanding in those eyes. And I knew this is my teacher, this is my guru.
The second part that has really surprised me is the Kundalini awakening. When I had seen people in the past that levitated and had Kundalini awakening, I thought it has been acting, or, I quite couldn't understand it. But right now, the Kundalini awakening that I get in front of Swamiji has been amazing, and I cannot describe it in words.
For centuries, science has regarded mystical phenomena as unnatural, non-quantifiable, and beyond its purview. Even today, the finest minds of the global scientific community struggle to explain these happenings, which are commonplace in the centuries-old Indian yogic tradition that Nityananda represents. But Paramahamsa Nityananda says, "There are no miracles. All miracles are perfectly scientific happenings based on natural laws not yet understand."
To awaken your Kundalini energy, you don't need to have faith in me. Faith in me is not a prerequisite for you to awaken your Kundalini energy. For you to retain the extraordinary experiences and expressions of Kundalini energy, you may need to test some of my words and practice some techniques and teachings. That's all. Otherwise, the faith in me is not a prerequisite at any level for me to arrive at your Kundalini energy.
Kundalini is not just a blind force like electricity. It is a conscious spiritual power of cosmic proportions. Once awakened, Kundalini rips through millions of years of our human conditioning, firing brand new neurons in our brain, opening up unknown strands of our DNA, flooding us with superhuman energy, retracing our mental blueprint, wiping out our most obstinate karmic patterns and catapulting us to a whole new level of existence. By awakening the consciousness of each individual, Kundalini opens the doors for a global revolution of consciousness.
When the Kundalini is awakened, naturally, mitochondria cell energy is awakened beyond your expectation. Any available physical exercises, yoga or gym or any available physical therapies can awaken that energy only to the level of 40%. It can raise only 40%. But our method of initiation, Kundalini awakening, is awakening the mitochondria cell energy 1300%. Naturally, that awakened mitochondria cell energy brings different positive effects on your system.
The extraordinary effects of Kundalini awakening can seem like nothing short of a miracle or hoax. Yet, to put to rest all speculation that what we are seeing might be hypnosis or mesmerism, a series of scientific tests were performed on Nityananda's disciples and participants of a meditation retreat under strict medical surveillance and controlled conditions. The results were astonishing. In the first such experiment, within seconds of Nityananda awakening their Kundalini energy, brain functions in the subjects leapt up the scale, instantly recording sharper focusing abilities, faster parallel processing, higher alertness levels, and rapid multiprocessing. Most significantly, while their brain was going into overdrive, the subjects themselves remained in a state of complete relaxation, comparable with the states of deep meditation or sleep. But the strongest proof of the effects of Kundalini awakening comes from the post-activation studies conducted on these individuals. These studies revealed that elevated levels of cognitive and mental function endured in all the subjects for weeks after the initial activation.
I am Lakshmi, I am from Mumbai. And I have done management studies. Basically, I would like to tell about the Kundalini awakening experience that I had. The first experience I had, the Kundalini awakening and the levitation experience, was during the healer's initiation. Kundalini awakening is just a complete feeling connection with the master, and it's actually a ecstatic feeling where you're just one with the life, one with the energy. It has actually many healing effects in your body. Like, first is the weight reduction, and then many of the small illness, the diseases which are just growing, everything just vanishes from your being.
The following results are from the test performed on the participants at Inner Awakening, a 3-week meditation retreat held at Nityananda's ashram near Bangalore in India. 100% of participants recorded significant weight loss. 100% of participants recorded recovery from eating disorders. 100% of participants recorded recovery from chronic fatigue. 92% of participants showed marked recovery from rheumatoid arthritis. 78% of participants showed marked recovery from osteoarthritis. 79% of participants showed marked recovery from asthma. 71% of participants recorded marked recovery from chronic headaches. 97% of participants reported recovery from depression. 89% of participants reported freedom from phobias. 82% of participants reported freedom from anger and frustration. 88% of participants showed marked recovery from insomnia. 76% of participants reported recovery from panic attacks. 76% of participants reported freedom from insecurity. 73% of participants reported an increase in mental focus. 71% of participants reported freedom from mood swings. The impact of these findings in a vast range of areas like depression therapy, functional enhancement, mind coaching, memory training, personal development, stress management and drug rehabilitation is inestimable. In the hands of advanced spiritual adepts like Nityananda, Kundalini awakening might be well on its way to becoming the ultimate natural steroid for the human race, triggering and sustaining powerful positive changes in virtually every area of our lives. Even as these extraordinary happenings are taking the scientific community by storm, Nityananda himself lives and moves as one amongst us, teaching, healing, initiating, and working tirelessly to preserve the mystical science of Kundalini, one of the innumerable spiritual treasures of the millennia-old Yoga Vedanta traditions of India that might be humanity's only hope for liberation in the centuries to come.